much you learn in boxing news from the Capital City here with former IBF world champion Darren Barker. Dale, what brings you to this part of the world today, mate?
Well, I'm here with Tony. I did a little bit of training myself. Not boxing, so don't get your hopes up. But so I went down to see Tony. Obviously, Kevin's top of the bill and that, so thought I'd come down to the weigh-in. It makes a change coming to them and not actually having to weigh in myself, which is always nice. So, buzzing for the show tomorrow as well.
Quality card, wasn't it?
Brilliant, really good card, and I can't wait. It's a good thing now. I'm really enjoying being a spectator. I'm buzzing.
Are you, you've been there, you've done it, you're world champion, no one can ever take that away from you. Do the boys look at you for advice, though? You know, you've been there on a big scene.
Did I always get nervous?
No, do they look at you for advice? You know, do you give them a
speech? Yeah, I think so. I think all levels. And I always did, you know, from my peers. And it always helps when you've got lads in the gym, regardless of the level. They're all going through what you're going through. It doesn't matter if you're fighting for a world title or you've got four rounders. You're all doing the work. You're all in there. So, I was quite vocal about how I was feeling to the lads and just getting any you know, negative energy, any positive things. I would just talk all the time. And Kevin's the same. Kevin Mitchell's the same down the gym. So it's good, you know. And if I can lend any advice, I always do so, you know.
Regarding yourself, Dad, what do you do with your time now? I'm forced into retirement due to injury, you know.
Well, I'm happily retired from boxing, that is, you know. I'm keeping busy, I'm doing other bits and pieces. I've taken up cycling, I'm doing a lot of cycling. I'm cycling across Cuba in October.
Right, for charity?
Yeah, for the British Boxing Board of Control for charity. So I'm doing that, so that's been keeping me busy, and I've absolutely fallen in love with it. I love it. So,
as your injuries holding up on that front?
Do you know what, cycling, I'm alright. I mean, it was the impact for me that's done me. So I'm in good nick, actually.
Do you still do your bits and pieces with Wayne Lill?
I don't. No. I mean, still in contact with him, but I don't do no yoga or nothing. But the cycling is taking up most of my time. I mean, I go out 3-4 hours at a time, and I'm absolutely buzzing off of it. I love it. But that I've got some other things in the pipeline, doing bits and pieces, you know, business wise, and yeah, all in all, just enjoying life now. It's nice getting a bit of normality back.
Spend time with your family as well.
Spend time with family and being happy with it. You know, whereas before I was never nasty to my kids, but you know, you're getting close to a weigh-in, you've got to lose bundles of weight. It was always about stone and a half for me, and it was hard work, and you take it out on the people closest to you. So it's nice now to spend some quality time with
them. Oh, that's brilliant to hear. Just finally, Dale, how do you see Kevin Mitchell going against Daniel Estrada tomorrow?
I think it's going to be a tricky fight for a few rounds, but I've seen him in the gym up close and he looks in fantastic shape. They've got a brilliant couple of game plans to work off of, a few decent combinations that I see that I personally think will work against Estrada, and I fancy him to go on by the end of the year, be world champion.
Renewed figure in Kevin Mitchell under Tony Sims, who better than to ask than you? You know, Tony Sims to have bought the breast out of Kevin,
he does, and he has that effect with people closest to him. He really does. And, you know, he did it with me, and he does it with Kevin. You know, he don't take no shit. He's just spot on. He's a blinding coach, and like I say, he's the best out of me, and most importantly now, he's got the best out of Kevin, and I think you'll see that tomorrow night.
Darren Barker, thank you for your time. Much appreciated.
Cheers.